Hello everyone, I welcome you once again to the online lecture series on accountancy. So this is the part 1 introduction segment 2 of the video. So if you haven't checked the segment 1 of the video, I would request you to go to the channel and press the video which is available in the playlist. So today we are going to discuss about importance, branches, basis and role of accountancy in a business firm. My name is Prasenjit Roy. I have qualified PhD in NetJRF and am Com in Accountancy and Finance. So let's begin. We'll begin first with the importance. So when we talk about the importance of accounting, we'll observe that it helps us to maintain systematic records of all the financial transactions. Okay. So when we say systematic records, it means like there is a proper set of accounting policies and accounting concepts, okay, and accounting standards which are maintained while recording these transactions, okay, this financial information in a systematic way in the books of accounts, okay, in the books of accounts, okay. So how this is done? The entire thing is quite large, but I will give you a brief idea. Okay, let's take an example of date. Okay, when suppose in a month we have 1 to 30, right? So we'll maintain systematic records by recording the transactions in the first, okay, then the second, okay, then the third, okay, then we'll end up with the last date, okay, of the month. We'll not jump at the end, okay, by maintaining on 30 the transactions of first of the month. Okay, so this is known as a proper systematic approach towards maintaining the record. Okay, there is a sequence to it. Each day accounting is done by the accountant. Okay, there would be no mismatch or mismanagement in maintaining the record. Okay, then we see preparation of financial statements. So financial statements are the statements which are prepared. Okay, these are profit and loss account. Okay, then we have, these are profit and loss account, then we have balance sheet, okay, then we have statement of changes, financial position, okay, in fund flow and cash flow, okay. So all this information is recorded and then transferred to this financial statements, which serves as a medium of communication to the management. Okay, then through accounting, okay, the progress of the company, okay, company's progress is monitored. Okay, is monitored where the company is heading, whether it's loss in the future or profit. Okay, so this is only possible when they have proper records with them, okay, of the transactions. So this helps, all this information helps in decision making. Okay, this is helpful for decision making of the management, right? Okay, and apart from this, it helps certain legal requirements. Okay, as per Companies Act, okay, Companies Act 2013, all the companies registered under the Companies Act needs to, okay, maintain annual report and publish it publicly, okay, each year. Okay, this will be constituting the operations of the business, okay, which is communicated to the shareholder and the common public. Okay, so these are the certain things which satisfies the legal requirement. There are taxation also, okay, then there are TDS also, okay, our employees provident fund, to name a few. Okay, so information is passed on to the interested groups. Okay, so who are these groups? We'll discuss it later, but the most important group here is the internal group, that is the management of the company. Okay, apart from that, we have owner, okay, who provides the capital, then we have creditors, okay, then government, okay, researchers, academician, etc. We'll get back to that in this segment as well. So what is legal evidence? So all these documents provide as a legal evidence, okay, a proof that the business exists, right, that the business exists. Okay, and business is operating with all these transactions. This is helpful for computation of tax. Okay, as we know, the company's progress, if it is in loss or if it is profit, appropriately or adequately will go for tax filing, or government may charge us tax on the profit we are reporting. Okay, now moving on. For settlement of merger, merger means we should all know what is merger. Merger means when two company they come up together to form up one company, right? So how would they form this company without knowing the value of this company? Okay, what would be the proper justified value of A Limited or B Limited? So this is only possible when they are recording, or when they are recording, or they are maintaining proper set of accounts, okay, for valuation, which helps them to merge together. Okay, so this is not possible without accountancy. Okay, so all assets and liabilities of A Limited would be reviewed based on the accounts they have maintained. The same goes with B Limited, it would be reviewed. Okay, then they will come to an agreement that this is the valuation of A, this is the valuation of B, together then we'll come up and then we'll merge together as A B Limited. Okay, so these are the few important points which highlights the importance of accounting, okay, for a business. Now when we move on, we'll see what are the various branches of accounting. So the first branch is financial accounting. Okay, financial accounting basically refers to, okay, which we have discussed, preparation of journal, okay, ledger, trading account, okay, profit and loss account, balance sheet, okay, fund flow statement and cash flow statement. Okay, so these are the set of accounts which are prepared under financial accounting. Okay, so basically here only financial information is recorded. Okay, financial transactions or financial information related to the transactions are recorded, okay, of a business enterprise. So coming to cost accounting, so it refers to that section of accounting where, okay, cost, okay, and expenses is only recorded, okay, and allocation is done on the basis of the information of cost to the various allocation of is done on the basis of is done on the basis of cost. Okay, on the basis of cost. So this cost accounting is mainly focused to manufacturing concern. Okay, it's not applicable to trading concern, but financial accounting is applicable to all the concerns. So whether trading, manufacturing, production. Okay, so another thing is that in financial accounting, both revenue and cost is considered. Okay, but in monetary terms. Okay, but in monetary terms. But in cost accounting, often cost might be assessed on the units of consumption. Okay, consumption such as electricity. Okay, or machine hour. Okay, or maybe liters, etc. Okay, so basis of cost accounting is, you can say, more flexible towards the units of measurement. Okay, now coming to management accounting. Management accounting is the combination of both financial accounting and cost accounting. Okay, and interpreting the results, okay, in the proper format and presentable to the management. Okay, it's presentable or presented to the management for decision making. Okay, for decision making. So this is only possible through amalgamation, or you can say bringing together all the information of financial accounting and cost accounting, and you can say present it, or you can say prepare the entire information, summarize them to the best possible way of making the management aware of the business operations so that they are able to take proper decision. Okay, so when you talk about social responsibility accounting, it refers to the accounting, okay, related to corporate social responsibility. Okay, like environment, okay, whatever cost related to environment maintenance has been done by the company, okay, or public utilities being provided by the company. Okay, these are all recorded or, okay, or kept into records under this accounting, okay, social responsibility accounting. And lastly, when we say human resource accounting, here all the transactions related to human development of human resource, okay, development of human resource in a firm is maintained, okay. So basically this refers to the training and development expenses, okay. So whatever kind of cost is involved, okay, training and development. Okay, so here basically humans are regarded as human, you can say human are regarded as resources, okay, capital, okay. So basically here whatever expenses is borne by the company in training the human resource is considered under human resource accounting, okay. So I hope you are clear with the branches of accounting. Financial accounting basically focuses only on the financial information, okay, or financial transactions. Cost accounting focuses in the cost recording of the cost or expenses in the company. It is more preferable in manufacturing concerns, and the units, okay, of consumption or the resources, consuming the resources are also considered alongside monetary information, okay. In management accounting, both financial accounting and cost accounting is taken together and transformed in the more presentable way to the communicated, so that it's communicated to the management for decision making. Social responsibility accounting refers to the corporate social responsibility expenses of the company, where records of environmental maintenance or accounting, providing public utility, all these things are maintained. And lastly, we have human resource accounting that focuses on the training and developmental expenses of, okay, recording of all these expenses, okay, how it's benefiting the company's employee, all these things are maintained, okay. So these are the branches of accounting. Now moving on, what are the bases of accounting, okay? So there are basically three bases of accounting, okay. So what are these bases? The first base is cash basis, okay. So under this basis, actual cash receipts and payments are recorded, okay. So here, so suppose we take the same example which we took earlier, okay. A Limited purchased a machine of rupees 10 lakhs from X Enterprise. Okay. Now we don't have the information whether it is in cash or it is in credit. Okay. So let's assume that here it's in cash. Okay. In cash. Okay. So here under cash basis, all the payments and the receipts which are done in cash will be recorded. Okay. There, in simple terms, no credit, okay, or no kind of accrued, okay, we're supposed to receive but we haven't received, okay, those kind of transactions are not recorded. Only those transactions are recorded where we are receiving cash in hand, okay, in our hand, and we are paying cash out of our hand, okay. Only those kind of transactions are recorded under cash basis, okay. But under accrual or mercantile basis, okay, suppose we strike out in cash but in credit, okay. So here A Limited is supposed to make the payment of 10 lakhs to X Limited, say suppose after 3 months, okay. Okay, so this will be recorded under accrual basis, okay. Why? Because payment is supposed to be made, it's not made yet, okay. Payment is to be, or income is to be received by, okay, X Enterprise, but it has not been received yet. These kind of transactions are recorded in accrual or mercantile basis. But when both this kind of cash basis and accrual basis is taken into consideration in recording the transactions, okay, say suppose, okay, and raw materials in cash for 3 lakhs. So this will be recorded, okay? This information will also be recorded under mercantile basis. So preferably, okay, preferably and in usual practice, mixed or hybrid basis is a norm where, by which all the accounting or books of accounts are maintained, okay? So now when we look into the role of an accountant, we see that he or she is a record keeper, right? So he or she is a record keeper who maintains the record and keeps a kind of a track of entire operation of the business through proper structure and systematic record maintenance. Okay, he is a record keeper. Okay, so he also provides the information whenever it is required by the users of the information, name it the management or the higher authority in the other department or the operations or the administration or the marketing or the promotion, name it anyone. So whoever is concerned with the information regarding the sales or regarding the purchase or regarding the various activities, okay, related to finance, okay, or financial information, it can be provided or it is provided by the accountant. Okay, so through this, okay, through this record keeping, they are also protecting the assets. Okay, they are protecting the assets of the business. Okay, why? Because the proper valuation, okay, proper valuation of the asset is maintained by the accountant. Okay, proper valuation. Suppose you have purchased an asset, okay, at a particular value, okay, this record is maintained by the accountant. Okay, so it has to be kept in track. Okay, it has to be observed by the business whether it's the same value in the future after 10 years or the value will decrease due to depreciation, etc., etc. So all this information will be provided by the accountant. Okay, so he also acts as financial advisor to the business, okay, regarding all this information related to finance, okay, or financial information is being provided. Okay, he suggests the management whether to acquire an asset, okay, or whether there is an alternative or what kind of accounting policy should the company adopt in order to, okay, control unnecessary cost, okay, and also avoid tax or save tax, not avoiding it, but saving the tax. So in that way, he also becomes the tax manager. And lastly, he becomes the public relationship officer. Okay, by communicating all this accounting information to the various users of the information other than the company's internal management or internal users. Now moving on, who uses this accounting information? So basically, when we talk about the users of accounting information, we'll observe that there are two groups of users. The first one is internal users, okay, who are the owner of the business, okay, the management, owner, management and the employees. Okay, so owners are those who provide capital, right? Owners provide capital. Okay, so they are interested for the business's progress. Right, so later on when we see that it's management is also interested for the business progress. Okay, lastly the employees, to know about the progress of the business, whether there is a scope of their increment in the salary or bonuses or etc. So all these parties are interested in the accounting information. Now moving on, who are the external users of information? So you will see we have creditors. Okay, creditors who provide money. They're interested whether the company is making profit or not, whether the company who has taken loan from them will be able to pay the money at a proper time or not. Okay, investors who provide money. Okay, customers are also interested to know whether the company is making profit or not, what kind of products they are going to launch. Okay, so it will be interesting in the market whether to purchase these products or not. Okay, who are the tax, then it is also, okay, reviewed by the tax authorities and the regulatory bodies. Okay, accounting information is also reviewed by the tax authorities whether the company is genuinely or is showing authentic, okay, transactions, or there is any mismanagement in the transactions. Okay, So this is also observed by the government. Okay, you'll observe that government are also a party who are interested in using this accounting information, and they observe whether the company is in that sector where they are producing proper good amount of or good you can say boosting the economy, or whether they are producing all those kind of goods by which employment is possible, okay, or the growth and development of the economy is guaranteed more, okay, compared to the other aspect or other industries. Okay, then lastly we have researchers and general public who are interested in studying the companies, okay, whether comparing the companies, various companies, what is the competition in the market. So all these kind of things are accessible only through accounting information. So hence we can observe that accounting or accountancy is one of the important subject which should be known by people or students of commerce management in order to understand companies' whereabouts. Okay, so it is helpful for financial management, it is helpful for financial analysis, okay, to understand the various aspects of finance. Okay, we need accounting information. So without proper accounting information, okay, a company cannot, okay, study, or a company cannot sustain its business. Okay, it would look into the fact how it is operating and what is the scope or room for development in its, okay, operations, so that it becomes a profitable company in the future, okay, venture in the future. Okay, so I have developed few questions for your self-test which would be helpful for you to review your own understanding. So what are these? Okay, number one, why accounting is language of business. Number two, what is the role of an accountant in a business firm? Number three, what is cash and accrual basis of accounting? Number four, who are the users of accounting information? So please send your answers to the alttutor@gmail.com. I hope you have clarified many doubts regarding accountancy. This is the introductory part, where this is a segment 2. So we have discussed about how accountancy is important and why it is important for the business firm to maintain all the financial information through accountancy. Thank you for watching. Please like, share and subscribe. Press the notification bell for more updates. Stay tuned for the next video. Thank you.